I'm planning to contest in the Lok Sabha election as an independent candidate. After filing the nomination, I will get back to you with the symbol and other details. I am raising this kind of issues also. My message is corruption-free, faster Bangalore. Since I have executed projects which are very vast, and I wanted to encourage the youth across the country to inspire, looking me as an example, to raise up in the levels which they can. Suppose I stand as a ward member, then whether I win or lose, again, nobody is going to watch me. Now, this is a Lok Sabha election. Definitely, people across the country are there. I have my old team members working in different parts of the country. So they will be watching this and they will get inspired. So at least, if not in the national level, they will also try in the smaller levels which they can try. From my childhood, I used to hear about this brain drain kind of things, many of my classmates, they have gone to US and various countries. So, but now we know that the IT hub is in Bangalore, and so if I can make an impact, that will definitely impact the country. There are people working outside the country, like Google CEO and all. They are Indians, but there may be someone who think about coming back to India and contribute for the India. My dream job was to work in defense, but maybe in my childhood I was a very silent person. I got rejected on the third day from the Indian Navy, but still I have a passion for it, and I am a son of a police. So, and over and above all these things, I believe in God. So I believe that some change I can make. Immediately after the election, we don't know which party will win. There is a possibility that independents also will come up. Independents are maybe going to make a crucial role in this election. So definitely there will be multiple discussions happening, and definitely I don't want to take any single rupee and become a slave to any party. I want to go by the topics which they discuss and according to the ethics which I have came up till now. Like any parent, they are also scared, because many of the, even from the field, I am getting the feedback that it's a dirty water. If you jump into that, you will become more dirty. All these things I am also hearing. But still, I gave them the confidence, and so they returned after long debates and discussions. Even my CEO asked me the same question when I left my previous job. So my answer was like, since my message is against bribery and corruption, I don't want to collect any fund in the name of election. So, but when I started campaigning, God was giving me different ideas. Like I tried in the cabs, I worked as a Uber driver, then I worked for Swiggy, which gave me a maximum reach to people, and which gave me the confidence that I can travel and reach people. Even if and my message is like a faster Bangalore, a corruption-free, faster, safe and a clean Bangalore. This is my message. Since I worked 17 years in various companies, and I was able to contribute in making the fastest telecom network in India. I was part of the team, I handled teams, different profiles I have done. So if I get an opportunity, definitely we can improve the situation in Bangalore. There are roadblocks like Manyata, Nagavara area and all. There are huge traffic blocks. So these can be improved. So in my career, I have even worked as a voluntary service and supported Kerala police as a traffic police warden. So as a telecom engineer, I can also walk into the control rooms or give my suggestions and make improvements. As I told, from childhood I had a passion to be in the defense, not for killing, but to save and protect. So I definitely have a passion to do something for the country.